Hey folks, it's Frithgar here, how you doing? Welcome back to Old Times. So, the question for today is, or for this week rather, is do you want me to use this beekeeping mod right here? And for a better description of it, go to the beginning of episode 10, which was the last episode, and I go through and describe it all in a lot more detail, but this is the mod. I think it would fit with this map really well. Do you want me to be able to use it? Yes or no? Head down below. Let me know in the comments section. It's your vote. It's your game. Now, the Kirovets has finished ploughing this field. It took quite a while. And it is absolutely filthy. We don't currently have a pressure washer. I have seen a pressure washer that I think will fit with this map fairly well. And I'm just going to show you that one. It's in miscellaneous, I think it is. Let's go through. I got all sorts of, it's this one here, the Karcher. It's 12,500 euros to buy it. It's trailed. You fill it up with water and you fill it up with fuel, and then you can use it to hose off anything that you've got. It does look a little bit newer, but there were machines like this around before the 80s. They were sort of big, very loud. The pressure wasn't tremendous, but I have used ones, old machines that were manufactured before then. So I think this one will fit all right. So I might buy that one at some point soon. I'm not quite sure when. For a minute, let's just hop into this old beast, start it up and go up to the other end of the field. I think there might be a little bit left up there. I'm not going to start ploughing another field now. I just wanted to have a look at this one and show you the dirt on this thing, because we hired this one first thing in the morning, and it is now 5 o'clock in the evening, so it is very soon going to be time to bid fare thee well to this huge great beast. I wanted to show you now. We were going to be selling some corn to start off with, but I have since found out that the price that is being shown is actually the adjusted price. And if you have a look here, our adjusted price at the moment at plus 1.6 is 168. That is the adjusted price. So we'd actually get better just selling it standard to the transport company. That is absolutely appalling. Now, I'm not going to be storing potatoes or sugar beet, so what I'm going to do, I think, is just leave that in storage until we get a better one come up with an offer. And I'll just lower this down and we'll just plow up this tiny little bit here. We only need to do one single pass. There we go. Right, and I think the plow was on higher as well, wasn't it? Can't quite remember. But anyway, I'm going to park this one right here and we will just leave it. That one can go there and they will collect it from higher. If the plow, I think the plough was hired. Pretty sure we hired that plough as well. So let's switch that one off. So what we're going to need to do is we need to get some more money. So that means we're going to have to go here and we're going to have to take out the final £5,000. Now, I can get more. I have a mod that allows me to take up to £5 million in loan. But the interest rates are astronomical and I don't think that we could afford them. So we will go here, there we go, and I will just hire the harvester. Actually, I'm going to do this a sec and then I will show you the harvester in person, because this thing is brilliant. Right, we've just had a great demand come up for canola and we only have 2,500 litres of canola in there, so I don't think it's really worth bothering with right now. We will get 950. And that is at the shipping office. The shipping office is actually just down. Actually, I tell you what, we will do that. Let's just take a quick look at this machine first, though. Here it is. This is the potato harvester. And this thing is brilliant. That looks like an old international tractor there. That's what it looks like. It looks like an international tractor that has been then heavily modified to make this potato harvester. And the sugar beet harvester is similar. The sugar beet harvester comes in red, but this is an absolutely fantastic mod. I have tested it and I love it. But before we do that, we're going to just take this tractor and trailer. We're going to take the canola and we're going to go to the shipping office and get a little bit of money. And we'll also sell the eggs that we've got. I've got another 9 eggs, so let's just go and gather those as well. Let's just gather that one up. Eventually, we will find out what happens when we reach 100 coins. Because obviously we keep picking the same ones up over and over. So the whole map might just spontaneously combust, which probably wouldn't be the best thing to happen. But anyway, so let's just go and load this up. We can see how this spout works here. I did say that we were going to do some selling, so we can at least do a little bit of selling here. So we'll pull the spout, pull underneath the spout. There we go. So start filling. And it just works the same as the normal one. So we want canola. Start. And that loads nice and quick as well. That is nice and efficient. I like that. Right. We've only got the 2,500. Now, I got to remember how to get to the village. I've just gone completely the wrong direction, haven't I? All right. Let's go down this way. And what's in there? Oh, that's the field that we planted. That's the two small fields that we planted. They're now ready for harvesting. I'll tell you what, I definitely don't want to go that way. Back up here a little bit. I'm going to have to spin round. Right, I'll tell you what, I'm going to go to the village. I'm going to have to spin round here. I'm going to get to the village, and then we can sell this and sell the eggs. Well, that was easy enough. The tip point for the village is right here. So we'll tip our canola here, and then, right, how much are we going to get for this? Should be nearly 2,500. Excellent. Right, now we want to go and sell the eggs this way. Should be around, oh, there they are. Right, so we got 60 eggs, which is another 340 euros, another coin. I'm going to head back up now, put this in the field, and then we can start up our new harvester and take a good look at it. Right, here we go. We got 3,890 euros now, or 886, I should say. Let's take a good look at this thing. So let's get into it a minute. We have got all sorts of options. Show auto combine, active side. Yeah, we don't need to worry about those. So we start it up for it. A second. Cab looks fantastic. And it's a sound I really like on this one. Right, that's just the standard sound. When we get it over to the field, it's got even better sounds to it when it's running. I really love the sound of the thing when you unfold it and everything and get it ready. So have a look at it here from outside. It's got good animations on it. You have a look at the chains coming off the rear wheels, which are the drive. They're driving straight down to the big wheels underneath. I don't know if any actual harvester was made like this commercially, but this certainly looks like something that you would occasionally find on different farms. Sometimes you had farmers who were particularly good engineers, and they could cobble together just about anything you could think of. So there are all sorts of harvesters around. I'm going to do some research and find out if this is an actual machine or not. I would love for it to be an actual machine. I would love for there to be actually machines like this in the world, because this thing is so cool. Now then, we need to unfold. Excuse me. So unfold that one like that. There we go. And lower the harvester, which is the piece in the middle at the front there. That drops down like that. There we go. And then start it up. Now listen to this. Just put that away for a second. Now, are you listening? How awesome is that? You had belt slipping, you had the machine roaring, you had the whole package. That was absolutely fantastic. I was seriously impressed with that when I first heard it. I thought that was brilliant. It harvests really well as well. We've got nice animation on the fill. It's not harvesting really wide. It's good animation right on the part that actually picks up. This mod is fantastic. I love this mod. I am really impressed with this one. It is brilliant. And I really, really want there to be a real... Whoa, too far. And it also only holds 2,000. Okay, this is the bit that is going to mean that it's going to take a while to do this. Fortunately, we can drive on the crop a little bit. But only holding 2 ton does mean that it is going to take quite a while to harvest the field. So I'm going to just come up here very quickly with these trailers. And we will put the auto combine going. We'll see how it copes with doing this field. I'm hoping that it'll do it all right. That would be pretty cool if it could. And then we can just sort of follow it round with the trailers. And I am selling this direct. I am not putting this into storage and then having to manually shovel it all out. Right, why aren't you tipping it into the trailer? Now we need to go and have a look at this. What is it doing? There's got to be a reason that it's not emptying out. Oh, start. We got to manually set it to overload? Okay, the auto combine might still be quite slow. If you've got to manually set it to overload each time, it's a little bit slow on the animation coming out there, but it still works very well. We still have a good animation on it. I'll get rid of that a sec. Actually, I'll keep that up. I want to see what the other options are. You can stop overloading with O. Is it going to... Right, and then start overloading again. Let's show the auto combine. Right, that is all on. Unload mode driving. Let's just see what it does with the auto combine. Let's turn that off now. And H. Whoa, 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 whoa. Stop, 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 stop. It's getting a little bit ahead of itself. Doesn't like it when you have little gaps every now and then. It does get a little bit confused. I'm hoping that the auto combine can... I mean, if it can't, we'll just use the standard hired help to do it. Let's go forward and start it, and then we'll carry it on. What's it doing now? Oh, it's filling up the gap. Huh. Right, it apparently doesn't like it. The auto combine doesn't like it. Unless... Have I got it on the wrong side? No. No, it's not on the wrong side. It's, it just doesn't seem to like it for some reason. I guess it's because of the position of the harvester or something. Let me start that again. See what it's doing. Nah, it's not going to like that at all, is it? So, I'll tell you what we'll do. We'll turn that off. And then we will turn the auto combine off so it's just on standard hired help. And we will go back and forth on the headland a few times. So we've got room to turn round. So I can drive up through here. Let's just try it from the cab a second and see what we can't see that well from in here. But it's not too... I mean, it's not too bad. You just can't see the crop very well. Can't see where you are in the crop. But fortunately, it doesn't matter if you drive on it a little bit. So we can go, if we just drive up and down this end a few times, I'm about to fill the tank already. There we go, look at that. Oh, this thing is brilliant. Right, I'll tell you what, I'm going to cut out the end here. I'll do 5 or 6 passes on the end, and I'll do 5 or 6 passes on the other end, and then I'll get back to you when we're either full trailers or we're... ready to start working on the land work. I've tried it a couple of times. Whoa, what's going on here? Stop! Stop, 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 stop! Okay, I've no idea why it just did that. It has been working quite fine with the standard hired help. Yeah, I don't know what was going on there. Maybe it's just because I had it down and going to start with and it didn't like that, so it changed it. Not quite sure, but it has been working just fine. The only 2-ton tank is slightly annoying, but we can work through that. So let's just see if it will do it properly this time. Right, there we go. I don't really know what that was about, but it's now working fine. I have two full trailers just over here, so we're going to go and tip these, and that is probably we're going to have to take a rest for the night. I think we will work now until nighttime. Let's just see, where are we going to get our best price? Tatypoes, potatoes. I call them tatypoes because my son calls them tatypoes sometimes. So anyway, shipping office, 198 euros per ton. So we were going to go to the shipping office, which is quite fortunate because that's the one that is quite close by. And it is already full of potatoes over there. I might actually, considering the really small tank on it, I mean, I do really like this mod, but I don't like how quickly it fills up. How quickly it fills up is annoying. The auto combine not working at all on it is a little bit more annoying, but again, it's stuff that we can work with. So I have found a different mod, but I really didn't like it. It was too much clipping involved with it. And the actual width it was harvesting was half as wide again as the actual machine. So it was completely unrealistic, and I did not like that at all. So I will hunt around for some more mods that will harvest both sugar beet and potatoes and see if we can find something else, because I think that we can do slightly better than what we're doing at the moment. Maybe some tractor-mounted stuff could be good. How much are we getting per trailer for here? That is 890 euros for one trailer full. So we're getting 16, about 17, 1,750 euros for two trailers. And I have not done very much of the field at all yet. The other thing that I am finding slightly frustrating about this is I cannot just drive the tractor underneath the overloader. I've actually got to go into the machine, dismiss the worker, set the overloader going, and then when it's finished, then bring the worker back so that he can carry on doing a little bit more. I mean, if this was like a multiplayer type thing, then yeah, it would work just fine. But this isn't multiplayer, and I have no intention of it being multiplayer just yet, so we're going to have to sort of work with it. So I will see if I can find a different mod before we get to the sugar beet to save us having to spend absolutely ages over in the sugar beet as well. Because, I mean, this potato field is smaller than the sugar beet field. Right, so I've got to dismiss the worker, then set the overloader going. And it does start. I mean, overall, this mod is pretty good. Let me know what you guys think of it, because I'm quite pleased with it. It's just some little frustrating bits of it, like this, in particular this overloader. It would be nice if I could just travel alongside it down the field. Something else that is a little bit annoying is the way that those trailers are moving around the field whenever I use the overloader. But again, that is just something that I can learn to deal with. Let me just make sure I'm back far enough before I set the hired help going again. Let's do that. There we go. So he'll come down here, and I tell you what, I'm going to do a few slices across the end of this, across this end of the field, before I do anything else. And then I will get back to you just before we finish up for the day. Right, we have done the two headlands, and I'm just starting on the land work now. I'm just doing another slice down through here. So I've done a bit up there, a bit down the bottom end, and just putting in this load into the trailer, and then I think it'll be another 1,000 on the potatoes. So I'm just using standard hired help, and it's all right, but we do have to keep getting out to... Let me come out of cab so that we can just sort of admire this machine working. It's slightly annoying having to get out of cab each time to get into the machine, turn off the hired help and so on every time that I want to dismiss the worker. I don't think he's going to turn around properly there. Oh, maybe he will. Ah, excellent. So, yeah, it's slightly frustrating on that, but it's something that we can live with. We can sort of, you know, accommodate that. But I am thinking that I will try and find a different set of harvesters, because normally if you can find a potato, there is a sugar beet one to go with it. But I mean, if there isn't, there isn't. Well, maybe we'll see if we can find a tractor pulled one. I'm not quite sure. There we go, he's full already. So let's just go and get this one. I'm going to sell one more load tonight, and then we're going to park her up and we'll carry on in the morning. I will finish this field with this harvester. So we will finish this in the next episode, but if I can find another potato harvester or the sugar beet harvester that I'm kind of itching to get, I will show it to you at least in the next episode so that we are we'll be ready to go next week with our sugar beet harvest. So it should just be 1,000 to go in there. And I'll let this one carry on. It will fill up while we go and tip. Yeah, that's exact. That's all full. So this one can keep going. Let's skip out. Hop into here. And we will go and sell this down in the village. Has the price changed just from 9 ton of potatoes? I don't think it will have changed very much. No, not really. It's not really made any difference to it. That is the good thing about having such small quantities, is it does not have that much of an effect on price. Obviously, if we're doing hundreds of thousands of litres going in every time, then it has quite a major effect on the price. But anyway, the week's question is, do you want me to use the beekeeping mod? I'll just show it to you here very quickly. It's this one here. It's got its own private section where you get water and milk and wood chips or wood. I think there's a couple of different options that you can put into that one. You make beehives, you collect all the honey, and you put them together into these so that you can make cereals and met. I'm not sure what met is. Water and honey. I'm assuming that it's mead. And then you've got a diner that you can sell it all in. I think it's an absolutely fantastic mod. The appearance of it is definitely before 1980. I would say sort of 50s or 60s even. Maybe 70s, I'm not quite sure. It's an American-style diner, and I'm not very familiar with sort of when it would have been, but it does look pretty good. So that is an option. If you would like me to use it, or if you wouldn't like me to use it, head to the comment section down below. Give me your opinion. It is your vote. It's your game. So that is all I've got time for today. If you enjoyed this episode, then please head down below and give me a like. And if you really enjoyed it, then please go and tell your friends all about me. Get them to watch as well. That would be awesome. But until next time, again, thank you very much for watching. This is Frithgar. Goodbye, and see you later.